What's your experience like getting to work on the set of Luther?
Oh, that was many, many years ago now. Brilliant. It was really exciting. I got horrifically beaten up in that. I think for a while at the start of my career, I was a victim. How the tables have turned. it's interesting as well. And then when it first came out, and I think a lot of actors get this as well, if your character's been killed or something traumatic has happened to them, everyone's mothers and fathers watch it. And it's like, oh my God, they get so upset. My mum was like, my wee boy, oh my God, they killed you. And I'm like, Mum, I'm alive, I'm here. It's like, it's fake. But I think because they see it with their eyes, it just is so impactful, you know? But it was great working in that set. And that was the first time I'd seen an actor who, to keep in the zone and be prepared for the scene, he would listen to music. And actually, so many actors do that. But he had massive cancellation headphones even back then, and he was just in his own world. Where, as a young guy, I'm like, "Hi, I'm Mark." It's like, leave me alone. Turn the music up.
Last Kingdom coming to an end. What are the things that you will miss about the show? And what are the things that you, other than the costumes, obviously, that you really won't miss about the show?
I suppose all my friends. Then this is the. In other shows I've definitely, made new acquaintances and friends for sure. But in this show, like, everyone is my pal. Like, we all have a WhatsApp group. We all keep in touch. We've been on holiday with each other. So I think that's what I'll miss, knowing that I won't get to see them as much. We've even talked about, occasions of, hey, maybe we should have like a thing where we meet up every couple of years, sort of convention for ourselves. things I won't miss. I think sometimes being away from home, because you're away from home so much, you do miss a lot of events, family events, being with your loved ones. So maybe that, because it's so hard to just go back for a couple of days, especially as we were filming over COVID there. We were very much there for the entirety of the shoot, so that was quite tough, but I won't miss that as much. I would say, as an actor and a human being, sometimes the costumes can be a bit restrictive. Yeah. So, like, having to go to the toilet can sometimes be a bit of an issue. I don't think we have to specify much further. I'm sure lots of knights and, warriors in the battlefield had that problem as well.
Is it quite a physical role?
Yes, it's very, very physical. And it's really fun. And the great thing is, it's pretend. So... after it, you're like, oh my God, this is so exciting and brilliant, wow, this is what it must have been like. Yeah, but we have plastic swords. Do you know what I mean? And all the people that you're fighting are like stunt guys, so when you do tap them with the sword, they'll go down. It's not. But you do get a flavour of it. After it, the adrenaline rush is unbelievable. And what people kind of forget is, and actually when you're in the madness of it, and there's so many people, especially dressed in similar costumes, you are looking out for the stunt guys you practice with, but all the Vikings look the same when they're in armour. So it's very much like, oh my God, everyone's just running at me. Who am I going? I'm going to go for you. So then there's been a couple of times when I've attacked the wrong guy and then I've ruined a whole battle. I'm like, oh my God, because you're supposed to fight him, then he fights Alex, and then...
yeah. What's been your favourite moment working on Lost Kingdom?
Favourite moment? Mm-hmm. I think I've said this before, but there was a time when me and Arnis, who plays Citric, I think it was season 3, and it was either episode 4 and 5, and there was a big battle, and we all charge out from the forest, and we're all surrounded, and we were running out of time in the day,
And so all the cameras were set up, and we thought the lens that they were using on one of the cameras in particular was very tight. So if you go for a tight shot and someone's slashing about, like, there could be, you could be fighting air, and they wouldn't even realise that, you know, no one's there or whatever, because it's so tight and close, and it feels almost claustrophobic. So you can sell it, you know. But it wasn't like a, it wasn't a close up on Arnis and myself. It was a wide shot. So by the time we finished the fight, and they were just like, "Keep going, keep going." We're like, "Okay." All the stunt guys have kind of died. We were just pretending to like fight people. And then they had the additional artists there, you know, the extras, they were there, supporting artists. And so then we started interacting with them, and they didn't know what to do. So as soon as like we were slashing them with the plastic swords, they just all died and didn't fight back. So if you ended up watching it back, poor guy who's editing it together, because just would you just seen all these Vikings just sacrifice themselves to this? Just be ridiculous. So I'd say that was good.
For your role in The Last Kingdom, were there any new skills that you had to learn?
Yes.
Other than the fighting.
Horse riding. I had to do an Irish accent, and that was really fun. And I said to all my Irish friends as well, you know, if I, at some point you can hear them Scottish, then I'll have to buy a pint. So I made sure that my accent was in top form. So yeah, probably that.
If you could appear in another Assassin's Creed game as a historical figure, who would it be and why?
Oh, that is very interesting. Historical figure. Maybe like someone like Napoleon. That'd be quite cool. I mean, he was a bit of an interesting character, you know? Yeah, someone like that.
To be on your knees.
I'd have to be on my knees. He definitely had small man syndrome, you know, taking over the world and all that, but he done all right. Feels of that, you know, forced him to, forced his masculinity to the edge, to the extreme. Yeah, maybe someone like that. Yeah, I quite liked an Alexander playing Alexander Graham Bell. I think that was quite a cool character to play.
It was a cool character, yeah. To be fair.
It's really hard to pick something. He was like the Tesla back in the day, you know, creating everything.
What do you think is the continued appeal of, you know, a Viking story? You know, this is deep into kind of antiquity, but you know, it's they're still used in kind of film and TV and books. What do you think? What is it still about? You know, the idea of the Vikings that still appeals to a modern audience.
I think it's because they are steeped in nature, you know. It's that idea of you could be taken at any minute.
Yes.
So people celebrate life even more. And I think that's what I appreciated with the show itself. And just thinking about that, because we have so many distractions, you know, our phones and like, everything just around us now, so it's kind of like we forget to be what it's like to be human. But back then, you did have harsh winters. It was about community spirit, similar beliefs, the clan systems, you know. Identity was everything. And you were only as powerful as the next man, you know. So I do think it's to do with that, the core of what human society really was. And I feel as if we are missing that more and more each day as we delve into the world of internet. And, you know, everyone's talking about, you know, microchips in our head.
5G.
Yeah. So I would say it's that. Very rarely, I think, I even realised that, you know, a couple of months ago when I was walking around a nice park, I was like, oh, I'm listening to music. I was like, oh, wow, you'd never get that back in the day. And then I took my headphones, my headphones died. And I was like, oh my God, it's so nice to hear the wind through the trees.
So just to appreciate nature and just to kind of be there and make sure your phone is off. And
totally.
And
like very,
walking around.
100% and present.
Yes.
I was like, whoa.
Yes.
So, yeah, maybe it's that. That's cool. What it felt like for me.
Thank you.
Is there any scenes or roles that you got to play that you stood back afterwards and just thought, wow, I couldn't believe I got to do that?
I'm doing a project just now and it's kind of like that, but there's I'd say I played Macbeth when I was younger. I was like 25 and that was quite cool, especially to do it so young. Very much that, really. It's just a great part to play, and normally you kind of get cast as Macbeth when you're mid-30s, so it was really, really exciting to do that so young.
Yeah.